Hi, I'm Jenny with the city, and welcome to our digital unveiling of the new sculptures in the Cedar Park Sculpture Garden. It's located here at the Cedar Park Recreation Center on Main Street in the Town Center subdivision. Our multimedia specialist, Kevin Riley, caught up with the artists to talk about their works.
My name is Randy Halstead. I've been in Cedar Park for about 14 years. I started actually back in the 80s doing chainsaw carvings, and then it just kind of evolved. All right. I kind of like doing sculptures because there's no real set way to do it. People either like it or they don't like it, you know? So I really like doing things that just basically come to mind. We're installing three of my sculpture pieces that I made earlier this year for the Cedar Park Sculpture Garden. The first piece I call Dancing, because when the wind blows, it kind of bobs and weaves, so it kind of does a little dance in the wind. Next piece I call Winging, because I really just wasn't sure what I was building when I started with it, and I was kind of winging it. So once I wound up with the wings, I decided that's really what I had to call it. The third one is called Twisting. I like curved lines a lot. So as you can tell, there's not many straight lines in my pieces. So that one wound up being Twisting. I love the fact that people can just walk and check them out as they're on their walk. But I really think it's an asset to Cedar Park, particularly to have local people be able to show their stuff here.
My name is Anthony St. James. I have been sculpting since a teenager. I met a sculptor in college, and it just clicked. It just something stuck in my mind that there was a possibility. It's my passion. There it is. I plan to do it the rest of my life. I love to use repurposed metal and give it a new purpose from which it was originally intended. And there is something about working with your hands that makes you feel good at the end of the day. Jay's a girl is 9, and she's a Jack Russell Terrier, and she goes everywhere with me. Especially on installs. She's my little helper, and she really enjoys coming out. This is Freshwater Cowgirl. I've always wanted to create a mermaid, and I decided to go large scale and have her as she's emerging from the ground. People can have their photo taken in her tail sitting on the ground. That wasn't intentionally done, so I scaled it to that size. She seems to be a crowd favorite. Bicycle is called Remember When, and basically, it's to bring people back to their childhood when they first experienced their bike and their freedom of being able to ride around their neighborhood and visit their friends. I'm taking it back to my age when I was a child, for one thing. I was in Kerrville, Texas at an antique shop, and I found these two giant industrial wheels. Didn't know where they came from, but I just knew I had to have them, and I thought I'll use them in a sculpture at a later date. I started thinking about it, and I finally decided I'll just make a giant bike out of them, and I will scale it to those wheels, and that's the story behind the size of the bike. This will be my 56th public sculpture I've had on display, and I plan to at least do 100. Right now, I really enjoy public art and letting the public be able to view art for free.
I'm John Mark Luke. I've always had the need to work with my hands, and that's what I find most rewarding, most fulfilling. I'd rather, you know, hit something with a hammer than press a keypad. I like to reuse stuff. One of my favorite adventures is to go to the metal salvage yard. Any shapes or any forms that kind of look kind of weird, I'm usually gonna buy it and pick it up and take it home and use it at some point. This is my sculpture, and it's titled Cosmic Pie. It's made of a stone cutting wheel and rebar. The foundation here is some 2x8 pieces of wood that I made in a circular motion. My idea for the sculpture was to give it movement. I don't create the piece on a piece of paper and then have somebody duplicate it. It takes form as I'm creating it. You know, as I start creating it, it takes up a life of its own. But whenever I started putting this thing together, I noticed how it was kind of moving. And I said, well, that would work really well, especially in high winds or something like that. It just gives it a little kinetic quality, you know? It makes it almost seem like it's coming alive in a way. I encourage everyone to come by and just take a stroll through. This lends itself to people that wouldn't normally go out of their way to view art, but if they walk through here, a lot of times, you know, it's unexpected. It's a great way to spend an afternoon. It really is.
My name is Reynaldo Alaniz. I used to enjoy painting, so I thought I could do that, you know, and until I met the wife of a doctor I used to work with. I asked who made the sculptures, and the doctor said, well, it's my wife. That sort of shook me up in the sense that I thought that very few people could handle such a material so hard and so on. So I got interested in it, and so I started on small pieces, and I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it more than painting, so I kept it up. The title of the sculpture is Madre. This is one solid block of rock. It's about 54 inches tall. I've had to estimate it must weigh around 2,000 pounds. I think it represents a bond between a mother and a child and the love that mothers have for their children. I think it's in me, for me, that's a way to express myself. It's always an adventure to start a stone, and it really is satisfying for me. Maybe some kids will want to do art. Our teachers can come out here and show the work, and they might be inspired to start working as artists.